What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to a brand new Liverpool Transfer News video, and we have some very important updates to the Thiago Alcantara to Liverpool transfer saga. So if you are excited for this video, leave a like, subscribe, because 60% of you guys watching aren't subscribed to my channel, and turn on the bell notification so you never miss the latest Liverpool Transfer News updates. And Christian Falk, the very well respected, knowledgeable German journalist who is very close to Bayern Munich, posted an update about the Thiago situation. So other new journalists and some newspapers actually said that Man United already made a bid for Thiago, and Man United are very interested in Thiago, which is a little bit of a nonsense to me, because they just signed Donny van den Beek for like £40 million, and why would they sign another center midfielder when they have other areas of the team that they want to strengthen? So this is what Christian Falk has posted: Liverpool FC are still in talks with Bayern Munich about the Thiago transfer, and Man United have not submitted a bid yet for Thiago. He can exclusively reveal that, and he's working for the Sport Bild newspaper, so he's quite knowledgeable on all things Bayern Munich. And let me know, is it concerning for you guys that Liverpool are not linked with a fourth choice center back this summer? We are seeing links to wide forwards like Ismail Assar, center midfielders like Thiago. We already saw signed a left back, but we are not linked very extensively to a fourth choice center back. And Jurgen Klopp said that he wants to have four center backs, four senior center backs for the Liverpool team. So will Liverpool go into the new season with Phillips and Kumatio as our two center backs fighting for that fourth choice spot? Are Liverpool just doing some work behind the scenes? Let me know if that is concerning for you guys. It is a little bit. Maybe the Thiago signing would allow Fabinho to be our fourth choice center back. Some Liverpool fans already said that the reason why, you know, Fabinho will be the fourth choice center back is that when we changed some players in the Community Shield final, Joe Gomez went out to be right back and Fabinho from center midfielder dropped back to the center back position. And when we only had one fit center back, Fabinho was the player to play center back. And because Thiago can play in pretty much the same position as Fabinho, it would allow Liverpool to maybe put Fabinho as a center back and Thiago as a defensive midfielder. But I also think that it's better to have a backup for Mane and Salah than to sign a fourth choice center back, because as I said, we have Phillips, we have Kumatio, we have Fabinho who can play as a center back, we have Matip, Gomez, Van Dijk. So we have potentially 5-6 players to play at center back, but we don't really have an out and out replacement for Sadio Mane on the left wing. Ismail Assar would be a brilliant solution for that, I think. And Jan Aga Fjørtoft, who is a Norwegian journalist, he's also well connected in German football, said this: the Thiago transfer for Liverpool is getting closer. Thiago wants to play in the Premier League. Liverpool are the big favorite to sign him, but could another Premier League club try to hijack the deal? Karl-Heinz Rummenigge, the CEO of Bayern Munich, has actually confirmed that we expect an offer for Thiago in the coming days, which is very telling. Basically, it's an open invite for Liverpool to make a bid for Thiago. And Catalonia-based news outlet Sport are claiming that Barcelona will have basically a free hand to sign Wijnaldum from Liverpool as soon as the Thiago transfer goes through. So there is, I'm seeing more and more journalists say this, and this is now gathering pace because Van de Beek was one of the primary targets for Barcelona. He's now going to Manchester United. It leaves basically Wijnaldum as Barcelona's number one center midfielder target, and they already sold Rakitic to Sevilla, or maybe let him go for free. So Barcelona are definitely signing a center midfielder in the summer. The newspaper had Wijnaldum's face splashed across its main sports page, and they are saying that he is a key target for Ronald Koeman, the new Barcelona manager, but it will only happen this summer if Liverpool complete the signing of Thiago, who has been, of course, heavily linked with a move. It makes a lot of sense. Why would Jurgen Klopp be willing to let one of his most important players leave without a suitable replacement in terms of raw ability. Thiago is maybe slightly better than Wijnaldum, but of course Wijnaldum is more settled in Liverpool's midfield. Thiago would probably need to learn a little bit how exactly Liverpool play. So since Liverpool won the Champions League last summer, so in just 1 year, Liverpool only signed two senior players, Takumi Minamino for 7 million and Tsimikas for 12 million. And of course, the old saying that you need to strengthen your squad while you are at the top has largely been ignored at Liverpool since Liverpool started off on their year-long trophy hunt by beating Tottenham in the Champions League final. Jurgen Klopp knows that Liverpool needs fresh faces to spice up competition for places and to ensure that his players can see that the club is determined to build on recent success. But it's also reality at Anfield that no major signings will arrive at Anfield this summer until some senior players leave. So Marco Grujic, Harry Wilson are all for sale, and I think that Liverpool are just waiting for them to be moved on. So then Liverpool can use those funds to basically buy some players. And don't make the mistake of assuming that all the other top clubs have funds to spend while Liverpool have not. All the other top clubs, except Chelsea, took out massive loans, like 100, 150 million pound loans to spend on transfers, and those loans will have to be paid back in the next 3, 4, 5 years. Chelsea had like 200 million in the transfer budget because of the Morata and Eden Hazard sales, but Liverpool are just not willing to go into debt for like making transfers. Liverpool are losing approximately 3 million pounds every time that Liverpool have a home game without fans. And also, like every other Premier League club, Liverpool must pay a rebate of around 20 million pounds to the broadcasters, which will be due next season before a ball has even been kicked in the Premier League next season. Liverpool are already over 30 million pounds down in terms of money that they had expected to earn. That figure will climb with every Anfield fixture that is played with no fans in attendance. So there is a key that can unlock the door, but it is in the hands of Wijnaldum, according to ESPN, the Dutch midfielder, of course, who could go to Barcelona. Wijnaldum, if Jurgen Klopp wants Wijnaldum to stay at the club, then he risks losing Wijnaldum on a free transfer next summer. Barcelona are very keen to sign Wijnaldum, and more Barcelona-based newspapers are running with the story that Wijnaldum is one of Barcelona's top transfer targets. But if Wijnaldum stays at Liverpool, then Liverpool probably won't push or cannot push to sign Thiago, who is also out of contract next summer, and he refused to sign a new contract, just like Wijnaldum. So that's a big conundrum that Liverpool face. Do we spend money on Thiago in the knowledge that Wijnaldum could stay for one more year? And I don't think Liverpool can afford to sign Thiago right now and to keep Wijnaldum as well. It looks like it will be one or the other. And of course, the results on the pitch could be one element that could change everything. If Liverpool make an unconvincing start, and there is of course a chance for that because we play Arsenal and Chelsea in the second and third game weeks of the Premier League, then a new signing may become a necessity. So we need to watch the situation very carefully. What would you do if you were in Liverpool's position, if you called the shots at Liverpool? I will be honest, I would sell Wijnaldum to Barcelona and bring in Thiago for a little bit like a similar transfer fee, just to freshen up the squad, freshen up the team. And also because we have many midfielders who can play in Wijnaldum's position, but we only have Fabinho and potentially Henderson to play in that deep-lying midfielder role, Thiago would really add more options to Liverpool's midfield. Karl-Heinz Rummenigge, the CEO of Bayern Munich, gave an interview to a German newspaper called Welt am Sonntag, and this is what he said. "We are expecting an offer from another club in the next few days. He told us, Thiago, that at the end of his career he would like to try something new, and the Premier League and Liverpool is a great challenge for him. The Bayern CEO confirmed already that Thiago is leaving Bayern. It's just a big question whether Liverpool can negotiate a transfer fee that is good enough for both Liverpool and Bayern Munich. I really, really hope that we can do that. And Dietmar Hamann was quoted in the Liverpool Echo saying, "Thiago pulled out in the last minute from the transfer negotiations with Bayern Munich, and he said he might want to do something else in his career." Hamann said this, "I would be very surprised if Thiago turns down a contract for Bayern Munich and he hasn't got something else lined up. So I'm sure he has got an offer from Liverpool now already. It is probably about the transfer fee now between Liverpool and Bayern Munich. I have got to say that I never felt he's a defensive or a holding midfielder, Thiago, or he can play that role. But I've got to say that he was absolutely magnificent in the Champions League for Bayern Munich. The way he pulled things together, he's a brilliant footballer, as we know. So I think he can add a different and a new dimension to Liverpool's midfield. I would be surprised if he doesn't end up in Liverpool." And that's what former Liverpool player Dietmar Hamann said about Thiago. And of course Hamann is German as well, so he knows quite a bit about German football and Bayern Munich too. And I'm so happy to report this, that Hertha Berlin's chief executive Michael Preetz, or Michael Preetz, I should pronounce him because he's German, in a German way, has suggested that he's keeping a close eye on Marco Grujic. Marco Grujic was, of course, on loan at Hertha Berlin for 2 years, and he has been training with Liverpool. He was in pre-season training, but I don't think he's in the plans of Jurgen Klopp. We don't need him, and we want to sell him. And this is what the Hertha Berlin's chief executive said. "Grujic is a Liverpool player who spent the last 2 years on loan with us. He has been in training with Liverpool for a few years, and unlike last year, it was Liverpool's declared wish that Marco Grujic should take part in much of the preparation there. Then there will be certainly a decision made in England about Marco's immediate future. Will he be loaned out again? Is he for sale? Will he be part of the Liverpool team? That cannot be foreseen at the moment." So I think what happened actually is Jurgen Klopp wanted to actually take a look at Marco Grujic, take a closer look how much he improved in the last 2 years. Is he ready for Liverpool's first team? And maybe Liverpool are waiting cautiously on whether they can agree a transfer fee with Bayern Munich for Thiago, because if they can't, then it's better to keep Grujic than to loan him out or sell him, because then we need more numbers in the defensive midfielder department. So I think this is actually a very smart tactic by Liverpool and Jurgen Klopp. And also Jurgen Klopp wanted to see how much Grujic improved. We don't know his judgment. We don't know what he saw, what he liked, what he didn't like. Of course, he won't come out publicly and say that. But I think privately, Jurgen Klopp already knows the future of Marco Grujic. And I'm eagerly awaiting his decision. Will he sell Grujic or will he keep him? A big question awaits Marco Grujic's Liverpool career. And we already have a little bit of an injury situation at Liverpool, because Jurgen Klopp still is not sure whether Henderson and Matip will be fit for the start of the Premier League season. Luckily, of course, we have Joe Gomez and Van Dijk fit and ready and available, but this just shows that if Matip is not fit, then Fabinho will probably have to slot back into centre back if we are to suffer another injury to either Gomez or Van Dijk on international duty. And I just hope and pray that in this week, the International Football Week, no player gets injured who plays for Liverpool. And this is what Jurgen Klopp said: "I think Matip and Endo will be in parts of team training this week, and we will see. Of course, the longer they have been, in team training, and the better the chances, but I don't know in this moment." And also Trent Alexander-Arnold is of course expected to be fit, but he missed basically pretty much the Community Shield and the Austrian training camp through injury as well. So we already have Matip, Henderson and Trent Alexander-Arnold a doubt for the opening game week of the Premier League. I'm not sure if you have watched the BBC documentary titled Liverpool FC, The 30-Year Wait, but I highly recommend it. It's a brilliant documentary. And in that, Liverpool manager Jurgen Klopp remembered how he got the call when he got offered the Liverpool managerial job. We were on holiday in Lisbon and I got a call from my agent, Jurgen Klopp said. He told me about the interest of Liverpool, so our plans at that moment looked completely different actually, because we wanted to make more holidays. I told my family and my boys were immediately like, yes! I looked in my wife's Ulla's eyes and she was, when? When you make such a big promise like I did when I left Dortmund, that we were going to have a full year to ourselves, and after 4 months you come around the corner with different plans, you have to ask at least. I was pretty much on fire from the first second really. Liverpool didn't have to convince me. And that is, I think, a brilliant story. Liverpool's owner, John W. Henry, explained a phone call with the Liverpool director, Michael Gordon. And he said, I first found out about Jurgen when I was still really a student of the game of football and thinking that is the type of football I want to play. I think they called it the heavy metal football. Mike Gordon called me one day and said, we are going to have a chance to meet with Jurgen Klopp in New York. To me, that was one of the most exciting phone calls I've gotten during the 10 years that we have been with Liverpool. He's a large man with a large heart and an incredible passion for doing things the right way. And I just wanted to share this brilliant story with you guys. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. It was a lot of fun to make. Have a nice day. See you later, guys. Goodbye.